Hi folks, I'm Littleton City Manager Jim Becklenburg, and this is Around Town with Jim. We all know that Littleton is an exceptional place, in no small part thanks to the many organizations working hard to make life better. Each year, the City of Littleton supports worthy causes and groups with grant funding. This year, we were also able to add additional funds for youth programs thanks to our share of proceeds from the sale of the Denver Broncos a couple years ago. Today, I'd like you to meet some of the wonderful people helping us lift up our neighbors by doing things like rescuing animals, supporting youth development in schools, delivering healthy meals to people who are elderly or homebound, and providing workforce training to the neurodivergent community. Let's take a look.
My name is Mindy. I am the development manager here at the Humane Society. We are proudly a really small shelter here in Littleton. We can house up to 60 dogs and 60 cats. We opened in 2009 to service the community because there wasn't a shelter in the area. We're just that small little shelter with the little engine that could, I guess. We provide a low-cost vaccination clinic, microchipping, spays and neuters for the community at a low cost. And then also, if there's a stray dog or cat, they bring their animals here. If someone goes to court or the hospital, we also safely house them. My favorite thing about my position is my community outreach, getting to work with kids. The kids are the future. If they don't see the need for a shelter like ours, you know, that nothing's ever gonna change as far as making a difference in the world, in the animal world of overpopulation. So the City of Littleton granted us $2,000 to help out with our community outreach efforts. I work with students, Girl Scouts, really any group that comes in, like younger people that want to learn about the shelter, about sheltered animals, the rescue world. So it's really a way for us to provide their education and just in turn, you know, help make a difference.
Say hello!
In the 14 years we've been open, we've helped over 20,000 animals either find their forever home or get reunited with their families. It's just really important for us to be able to you know, stay open, and without the City of Littleton, we wouldn't be able to do that.
Our district greatly benefited from the stadium grants. Without that funding, we would not have even been able to open the East Community Center. Through that funding, we were able to fund a staff member to help us take our plans and develop them and bring them to fruition and actually open the center back in the fall of 2023. That funding has been used to develop and bring in community partners to the center with a specific focus on activities and supports for youth in our community. And we continue to grow each day, and it is flourishing. At the Epic campus, that funding has been dedicated for summer program, and we are in the process right now of developing summer programming aligned to the pathways here at the Epic campus, so that youth who are not yet students at Epic but might be interested in exploring the pathways here have the opportunity to do so this summer. Littleton Public Schools is so grateful to the City of Littleton for this opportunity to receive funds through the district stadium grants. And as personally a Colorado native and a huge Denver Bronco fan, I just want to thank the Broncos for this opportunity as well.
I'm Nancy Falk, and I'm the Executive Director of Nourish Meals on Wheels. Nourish Meals on Wheels has delivered meals since 1968 to seniors in our community in need. Our founder, Virginia Baker, started creating meals in her home kitchen and delivered them to her neighbors. And we have been doing that for 56 years. Our compassionate volunteers delivered 200,000 meals in our community last year. 250 of those seniors live right in the City of Littleton. Part of what sets us apart is that we provide a sense of connection and belonging. That volunteer is the familiar face that drives away loneliness, that is bringing that connection. And this grant helps us do that for community right here.
Hi, my name is Kat. I'm the executive director of Dirt Coffee. Dirt Coffee is a nonprofit social enterprise serving Littleton with craft coffee and working with neurodivergent young adults on work development skills here at the bar. Well, we're really excited to have received a community partnership grant. I think that community is a staple and a value of ours here at Dirt Coffee. Within our programming, we have the internships on the bar, we work with employers on their disability hiring practices, and we also advocate within the community for early diagnosis, IEPs in school, and general resources for the neurodivergent community. So having a community partnership means we get to do more of that. Especially with the help of City of Littleton, we are able to have 3 events throughout the year, one for Autism Acceptance Month, and then we also do a block party in the summer, inviting local businesses and nonprofits to also share what they're doing here in the community. And last, we always like to close up the year with a brunch, because that's what our favorite thing is, and we vote in our Ambassador of the Year, so they will represent us. And we're able to do that, and it's made possible with the grants from the City of Littleton.
We're grateful for all the hard work of these organizations and many more who make Littleton such a special place to live. Find out more about grant funding by searching for the word grants at littletonco.gov. Thanks for watching, and tune in next time as we head around town with Jim.